Hello viewers, if you are new to the channel, please hit the like and subscribe button and share it with your friends. Also, click on the bell icon so that you get the latest information about the videos that are uploaded. Hello students, welcome back to the new video. In this video, we are going to start the chapter number 16, Light. In today's session, we will see the introduction and laws of reflection. Let us see what is light. When we look at the world around us, we see various objects and natural phenomena. How is it that we are able to see these objects and natural phenomena? It is by a complete process where light gets reflected from objects and enters our eyes. So, we see the world around us because of the light. When the light gets reflected or bounced back from the objects and enters our eyes, we see the objects. The cells that detect intensity and color of light present in the retina of our eyes convert this into electrical impulses that are sent to the brain. Our brain interprets these electrical signals into the objects that we see. So, we see the objects when the reflected light from the object reach our eyes. So, inside our eyes, in the retina of our eyes, there are cells that can detect the intensity and color of the light. And these cells convert this into electrical impulses that are sent to the brain. And our brain interprets these electrical signals and say the objects that we see. So, we can say that we see the objects when the reflected light from the object reach our eyes. Light always travels in a straight line, and this property is known as rectilinear propagation of light. So, light rays always travel in straight line. Light is made up of waves of energy that is emitted by vibrating electrons from an atom, just like sound waves are emitted by vibrating objects such as a tuning fork. So, what is light waves? It is waves of energy and that is emitted by vibrating electrons. We can say that the sound is produced by vibrating objects. In the same way, the light energy, that is the waves of light energy, is emitted by the vibrating electrons from an atom. However, sound waves are mechanical waves, whereas light is an electromagnetic wave, that is, it does not need any medium to travel and is only a bundle of energy. So, what is the main difference between sound wave and light wave? Sound wave is a mechanical wave, whereas light is an electromagnetic wave. Since it is an electromagnetic wave, it does not need any medium to travel. We can say that light is a bundle of energy. Now, let us see what is reflection of light. We see objects around us because light is absorbed and re-emitted from them. In some objects, such as surfaces of metal, almost all the light is re-emitted. Therefore, they appear shiny and our reflection can be seen on them. So, reflection, you have learned that reflection means the bouncing back of light rays from any surface. So, light is absorbed and re-emitted from the surfaces. In some objects, such as surface of a metal, most of the light is re-emitted or returned back. Therefore, they appear very shiny. Mirror re-emits maximum light falling on it, so we see ourselves very clearly in a mirror. We know that mirror, in front of a mirror, we can see our face very clearly. Why it happens so? Because mirror re-emits maximum light falling on it. When light falls on any opaque surface, the light is absorbed or partially re-emitted back to the same medium. Since only a part of the light is re-emitted, we do not see our reflection on an opaque, dull surfaces. Because opaque objects absorb maximum light and re-emit or gives back only a partial amount of light. So this type of bouncing back of light from opaque object is known as reflection of light. Now let us see what are the laws of reflection. When a ray of light falls on the mirror, the light ray gets reflected. The incident light on the mirror is called the incident ray, and the reflected light is called the reflected ray. The line drawn perpendicular to the plane mirror at the point of incidence is called the normal. So when we diagrammatically represent the reflection of light, these three words we have to remember, which are the incident ray, reflected ray, and normal at the point of incidence. Incident ray is the light on the mirror that falls on the mirror, that is known as incident ray. And reflected ray is the ray which is going back to the same medium. And if we draw a line perpendicular to the plane at the point of incident, that is known as normal. The angle measured between the incident ray and the normal is called the angle of incidence, and the angle measured between the reflected ray and the normal is called the angle of reflection. So what is the angle of incidence? The angle between the incident ray and the normal. Whereas the angle of reflection is the angle between the reflected ray and the normal. Now let us see the statement of laws of reflection. First law, the incident ray, the reflected ray and the normal all lie in the same plane. So which are the three lines? Incident ray, the reflected ray and the normal lie in the same plane. Second law of reflection, the angle of incidence is equal to the angle of reflection. Now let us see the diagrammatic representation of reflection of light. In the diagram, I represent the angle of incidence and R represents the angle of reflection. According to the second law of reflection, I is equal to R. That is, angle of incidence is equal to the angle of reflection. So students, I hope you have understood the topics very well. But still, if you have any doubt, you can write in the comment section. I will surely try to solve it as early as possible. Here are some review questions. Please solve it in your notebook. Thank you.